Hey everyone, this is Maxi10 here. Welcome to the review. Something really cool for the new Sega's thing is. You wonder what that is? A Sega Dreamcast controller. Yay! Oh, the Dreamcast controller is actually really comfortable. When someone look in. And have a look at the design of this. It feels really odd to me compared to the GameCube controller or anything. Yay. And you have a joystick. D-pad works really well. A, B, Y, X buttons, all of which are different colors, unfortunately. And have a look at different. And have a look at compared to the Xbox 360 controller. You see? There you go. And a green A, red B, yellow Y, and blue X button. But A is red button, B is for blue, X is yellow, Y is green. It is quite nifty. And you have a star button, which is a triangle shape. When you have a joypad, it has a circle on it. And have a look at the back of this. You have the two triggers. What should I compare to the Xbox 360 controller? You have the triggers inside as well. It also have triggers on the Sega Saturn 3D controller. Dreamcast. I don't know if you can see. It's blurry. Doesn't matter. And you have two slots for the VMU. Which are for the memory card and also Rumble Pack. Yay! And also have the VMU, which has a lid there. Can open a cartridge thing. You have a D-pad. Quite small compared to the Game Boy handheld. Sleep mode button. A and B button. Yeah, and a thing cannot go on. Well, which is a bit of a shame. And if you connect it there, that means you can. This is quite tough to do it. There we go. There you can see the screen and the controller. It's quite cool. Or even compared to the original Xbox controller, it has a memory card on the back of the controller as well. Yeah, this is quite cool. Let's put the camera down for a second. This is really stiff. There we go. Right, if you put this on the, here, right here, that means you can't see the screen. But you need to put this on the front. Because you need to do that. And yeah, let's put the camera down again. There we go. Yeah, one more thing. There's a controller slot right here, much like compared to the GameCube controller or anything. And a silver grey purple wire all the way there. And you can also put the wire on the there as well. Which is quite cool. And that's it. That's it for my review of a Dreamcast controller. And of course a little VMU. Oh not really. Just a review of Dreamcast controller. So, see you next time before I carry on the LP of Sonic Adventure DX. See ya!